All right, folks, how's it going? Sean Wilson, piano here. Listen, we're going to do a breakdown, live breakdown of Jacob Collier today. And I just planned this at the last minute. In fact, my choir was canceled for this evening. And you know what? I said, what am I going to do today? And I decided to go on live. We're going to do a live breakdown of Bridge Over Troubled Water, where we're going to listen to it together. And kind of go from there. So if you are here, welcome. Thank you for joining. Last week I had a cover on the keyboard. So let's remove that so that we can actually do this song. And what we're going to do is I'm going to bring up the song here and we're going to start from the top. And I'm going to start from the beginning of this song. And we're just going to listen to it together. And like I said, this will be a quick little thing here of Jacob Collier's Bridge Over Troubled Water. Thank you again for watching. Please do me a favor. Like the video, and let's share it out and let's get it out to more people. I'm going to start straight from the top without further ado and just kind of keep on going. So let's go.
When you're weary, feeling small, and tears are in your eyes.
So we have that part, and look at this chord right here. I'm going to change the screen here so you guys can see it. Nice chord there. Let's keep on going. That's kind of what I'm hearing. Again, you got to remember, we're adapting this for musicians, right? So the chords aren't going to be exactly as we hear them, but it's pretty close.
I will dry them all. I am by your side.
I like that part there. Yeah, those chords there. It sounds like a kind of a B flat chord. And then he goes to like an E flat 13 sus there. Right?
And friends just came.
So what he's doing, he's moving up to the 4. Right now we're in A flat. He's moving up to the 4, which is a D flat chord. So he's doing a C7 there, but I'm adding an A-flat on that. If you're not subscribed, man, go subscribe. We're trying to hit 100,000. I would love to see that happen, folks, today. That would be so cool. Share this video. So that's just a B-flat chord. Still to an E-flat chord there. Okay. Right. Okay, so that's cool. All right, let's go to the next part. So that's just the D flat chord, and then you have what I call inverted dominant, which is just an E flat over D flat. And then look at this chord here. I'm kind of playing as an A flat major 7 there, and I'm doubling up the G to give it that tension. That's a crazy chord. That chord is moving to an F minor, right? So it's moving to this chord here. So he's doing approach notes. It's not so much theory. It's just what notes would move to that chord, right? I can throw in a bunch of something like that. He can do something like that. That's such a cool part there. Looks like my video went out. Just give me a second. I'm going to turn the camera on, but I'm going to keep playing. I'm still here. I'm going to keep playing. Wow. Wow. I'm gonna have to play that whole section. So, so that's kind of... Wow.
When you're down.
So that, now he went to A flat. So that's what's happening there. And let me do this with the camera here. My camera is basically telling me it got too hot. So I'm going to need to, let me going to switch to my FaceTime camera here on the computer and allow the camera to cool down. And then we'll go back to that other camera. But for now, I can keep on going. So He went from A flat to E flat, and I want to hear that one more time. So, so that's kind of a nice progression to get from one key to the next. I'm in A flat. Right, so that's A flat. Let me change this camera as well. Where is that at? Thanks for your patience, folks. Nice, man, nice. All right, so that was nice. So let me keep on going and keep on going with this track and see what else we got here.
When you're
okay, now we got John Legend.
And out. When you're on the street.
So we have this. And then we have this kind of a phrase here. A flat, B flat, E flat. Listen to how that sounds, man. It sounds so nice.
When you're on the street, when the evening falls.
So. So. Yeah, that sounds like about right.
When evening falls.
Yeah, that sounds right. So it's kind of cool because in the right hand, I'm not changing. I'm just keeping a D flat chord there. It's just the left hand changing. Wow.
When evening falls, so hard.
So, I love that approach chord there. We have that C over A, which gives us a nice, a sharp five chord there.
So hard, I will come.
Wow. So, oh no, let me play that whole phrase. goodness, there's a lot going on there. I'm gonna try to hear it one more time.
So hard, I will comfort you.
All right, so. Right. So that's kind of how I'm hearing that phrase there. Let me see if I can. Yeah. So that's an that chord is an moving to like an F13 sus chord, which is like an E flat major 7 over an F. But there's a lot of additional notes in that.
I'll take your part. Yes, when darkness comes.
I like that part there. So like a minor 4, if we're in the key of E flat, the minor 4 would be an A flat minor. So that's that kind of move there. So that chord there. So this voicing here is it like a E flat 7, major 7. So pain is all that part there. That's kind of how I'm seeing that part there. So kind of moving from an E flat chord to an A flat chord with that.
In pain.
Yeah. Right. Really straight majors there, kind of how I'm seeing that part. Man, I heard something there. I need to bring up that part there. Okay, I love that. Did you hear that change in musicians? So instead of going and going to a diminished here, he went. So he's going from at least that's what I'm hearing. Let me see. Yeah. So half diminished to diminished. Really nice sound there. So y'all should definitely add that to your, you know, the options that you have there. Let me keep on going. I'm gonna change some of these sounds. Hold on for a second.
Oh,
That whole phrase there is kind of crazy. And as you guys can see, if you're looking at the screen, that's where I stopped. This is where I stopped recording. So I don't have the notes after this, but I'm going to still try to pick it up. But I want to hear that whole section there and play that. That part there. Yeah, I'm having a. I'm seeing that as F half diminished to a G diminished, and back to F half diminished but inverted. And then they end on a A flat half diminished with an added B flat. Something like that. That's kind of how I'm seeing it. Anyway, a lot going on there, but let me keep on going. Now, this is the part that I broke down last week. So check it out on the YouTube channel. Go check out my YouTube channel. Are you subscribed? And now he's in B. He went from A flat to B. So let's try that. So we have this. To a D flat 13 sus, and then we go to a C dominant, and then we go to B. And I think what I want to do for this next part, this is where Tori Kelly comes on, and I really want to have the right sound here. So let me bring up Omnisphere again, because I want less piano on this part. Less strings. I want an actual choir now. All right, that sounds good. All right. So, let's hear this next part, Tori Kelly's part here. As you guys can see, it's a blank. So I haven't done it yet. We're doing it today. All right. Okay. So da-da-da-da-da. So we're going down. You know what, though? I like it, but I don't like how they're moving from I, E, like in the vowels. Let's see if we can get a different sound here for the choir. I'm going to choose, let me see. Actually, I think I want ooze. Yeah, I love that. I like that better. All right, so I'm gonna stick with that for now. All right, so Let's go to this part again and hear that out. And I want my camera back. All right, so let me change my camera back out, guys, and then we'll get back to let's see if we got this back again. All right. So let's start from the Tori Kelly's part, and I'll try to show that. And I'm going to give some thoughts on this part too. See, they're going in opposite directions. See that part there? Right. So I like seeing that part there as it's really an A flat chord to a C sharp minor. But I like seeing it as an E augmented. So see how rich that sounds? And so you just take your E, and instead of putting a B here for a major triad, you would have it as a you would have it as an E augmented chord. And so that would, and then you would check this B and move it up a half step. So sail on, silver gown. Da-da-da. Yeah, it's an E, not E flat. Look at this chord, man. Really good chord here. All right, so let me keep on going. I'm trying to go slow because I know people are going to watch this on the replay here, so you can grab the chords that way. Okay. And keep on going. Man, so did you hear how they went from B to A flat? So the C how, let's go into that part there. So C how would be a D flat 13 sus to a dominant chord, which is a staple transition in gospel. It's something I teach all on my channel about using that sound. Please check out my other videos. That's what allows us to transcribe on the spot, is understanding how chords move and work together. So, and then they go into the boom, boom, da, da, all that stuff. So let's see that part there. Oh, I need to put it back here. Wow. Oh, if you need a friend. Wow. So we have this a B flat chord. Then move it up a half step. And then E. And then A, B, F, F sharp. And now we're at the 5 of A flat. Now we're in the key of A flat. So that's kind of how the change went. Kind of went from the 5 of B flat to the 5 of A and somehow transitioned to that. Let's do it with them so you can kind of hear how that goes. Thank you. have that next part. So, need a friend. So, something like that. It was as those chords are just crazy, man. Awesome chords. So let's walk that down for you. And let me see what's going on, man. Simon Keys. Oops, I deleted the wrong thing here. That should be unlocked, but it's not allowing me to. There we go. So now we're at the, so they went from the, now what's happening here is he's trying to get to the six of a flat, which is a C minor, because he's in A flat, and he's trying to get to here. It's not the six, it's really an A flat over C, but we're trying to get to the sixth note in the bass. So the question is, how do we get there? And instead of doing a 2-5-1, so instead of going, he's doing, see this chord here? So he's going down half steps, in other words, in the bass to get down to the C, D, D flat, C. So that's kind of how I'm seeing it. I added some additional notes. And again, remember, this is adapted for piano. So I'm not using the same voicings Collier's using. I'm using voices that I like, right? Because it has to come from my vocabulary. But I really like that part there. And if you hear that, hold on. See, I did this. I got my thumb on this E and F, by the way, which is kind of crazy because I wanted to get more notes in. So I got this D with my pinky. I got the in the left hand, and I got the A flat and the forefinger. But in my thumb is pressing the E and F. And then I've got the thumb on the A flat. A, C, E, G, and my thumb could also double up on this B flat as well to give it kind of a fat sound there. So I'm doing, and then I have this chord here, and then this chord is like, I'm almost using all five fingers to play a note here. I got an A and a B, a an E and a G sharp, but I'm really just kind of doubling up. The thumb can play these. So those are dope chords, man. Let me keep on going. So you have a dominant chord there. B, I, okay. So this sounds, the ear should tell you that the key is changing, right? Because we are ear musicians, and so we should know, like the ear should be picking up that something is happening here that's changing the central tonality of the chord. So you can hear, you may not know when it shifts, but you need to be able to pick up, you know, there's something here happening that's different and that's changing the tonality of the song. And so that's how I know the key's changing right there. See, so now we're in B, and I don't even have the key up here. Yeah, we're back in B now. It sounds like, I'm not sure. Bridge. Yeah, so that's what I'm kind of seeing it there. That's a F sharp diminished chord there. And then to a B over F sharp, B major over F sharp. I gotta go in 10 minutes, folks. That's an E flat major 13. And then so that's kind of like a E flat major 13, and then I got a E flat minor 9, and then a C sharp minor, and then I have an E flat over G, something like that. So something like that.
Laying down, lay me.
And this is the part that everybody sings online. So if you haven't caught this yet, y'all go check out Jacob Collier on Instagram. He's posted a bunch of people doing this riff here. So the chords are pretty familiar only because you know, they're all over the internet at this point. If you're in music, you've heard it. And the reason why everybody likes that run is because it basically changes. It's kind of like changing the key in the middle of the run. So I'm going to show you what the chords are. Hold on. So we have this, so we have an E flat major kind of chord. Then we have a C sharp like minor 9. And then we go, this is the key changes here, and her run has to fit that. So we go to this kind of like an A flat over E flat. Right? And then even the next chord, I mean, the progressions are just kind of crazy. And now my key is all off now because of, so now I got to change the key again. Man, I'm just gonna put this back in C because I don't want to have to change it every 2 seconds. So we have this lay me down. Something like that. But yeah, so after the A flat over E flat, and then we have this, and then we go to the B flat sus4. Something like that. I'll try to play it with them so you guys could hear it in time. And then I'm going to be out, folks, because I have to leave in about 5 minutes. So remember, this was an impromptu thing. We literally decided, Cheryl's on with you today. Cheryl, go ahead and send them the link, any relevant links. Also find last week's breakdown from YouTube. If you can put that in the chat for everybody so they can see that breakdown as well. And I thank everybody for coming, but like I said, I'm going to be going soon. Let me just break down this last section here. Something, she kind of does some kind of crazy run there. Something like that. And then that chord there, I don't even remember what I played for the chord that's accompanying that run. Something like that. It's crazy. I mean, at this point, I'm literally just mashing down notes. The ear is like, whatever. It doesn't even know. It's like, Sean, what is he doing, man? He's just mashing down the notes. if it sounds decent, it sounds decent, you know? So I think that's the goal here. Let's just finish this out. Okay, I get it. All right, I get it. We're not even gonna try to break that down, folks. But yeah, man, thanks for coming. This was just kind of a quick run through of this song. Let me know if you liked it. And again, this is just adapted to piano, so kind of how I'm seeing it as a pianist. Remember, our job as a pianist is to build our vocabulary. And the way that you build vocabulary is to memorize songs. And then when you hear something and you say, well, Sean he's breaking stuff down on the spot, what you're actually hearing is just the chords that I have gathered from learning my own songs. So this is the reason why I say, you know, our primary job as a musician is to increase our vocabulary by learning songs and not just breezing through them, but to actually take your time. Don't feel rushed about the amount of stuff you have to do and learn and how far behind you are, and let go of all of that and just really take your time and learn songs. This is not a song I would recommend, just to be honest with you, that a musician kind of tackle for a kind of a first song to learn. It's just got the harmonies are so advanced that it's just not something that I find that a lot of musicians would use. So today's kind of more like a fun project. But if you guys are interested in learning songs, go ahead and check out my channel. I've got some songs there on every level that you can check out. And thank you again for coming. It was great, folks. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks again.